Good evening, chicas, chicos, I'm your DJ Chris in the segment Drama Rama. And as the usual, we pick real life stories from our senders. Stories where we can learn, experience from life, heartbreaks, or moving forward. In our story for tonight is entitled Clara, sent by our avid listener, Michelle. So let's begin.
I'm Clara, not my real name, and I want to share this story of mine to tell the youth to respect their parents and value their education. It happened 10 years ago when I had a fight with my mother.
Where did you came from? To tell you, Clara, it's already 11 p.m. I told you to be home before 6.
And so? I'm already here. Stop blabbering nonsense. As if you really care about my welfare.
Show some respect, Clara. I am still your mother. I do care about your welfare.
I know you're acting to be one. Crap it out. I'm getting tired of dealing with you. I wish you'd have died instead of my father. Because of you being war, he left us.
Watch your mouth, young lady. You don't know anything.
Do you think I'm still stupid to believe your lies?
Who are you?
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry for the disturbance. I'm Diego Saavedra. I am Clara's boyfriend.
Why are you still here, Diego? I told you to go home already.
Sorry, but I get worried that you will get scolded, so I wanted to explain to your mother why you came late. Ma'am, I am sorry if Clara's arrived late in your home. I am a varsity player and part of a basketball team. I had a practice earlier and told her to go home without me, but she insisted to wait for me. I am really sorry, ma'am. Don't get mad at her. It's my fault.
It's okay, Diego. I don't know that my daughter has a boyfriend. And I'm kind of relieved that you are an honest kid. I think you should go home now. Your parents might get worried about you.
Okay, ma'am. Good night. Good night, Clara.
Yes. Nonsense. Lunch break is over. Let's go back to our classroom, girls.
Seriously, Clara? You still want to attend Mr. Tan's class? I won't waste my time here in school.
But Kara...
Sarah is right. Let's cut the class.
Leslie, someone might report about us not attending his subject class.
I told you're brave, Clara. You were able to have an argument with your mother, but as simple as keeping the school, you were a coward.
Maybe we should invite Lair to the real world later.
Real world?
Yes, real world, where everything is fun.
That's why you have a boring life. Come with us later. Let's meet up in Plaza, 9 p.m. sharp.
Wear like something attractive.
Oh, okay. I escaped at night from our home. I told myself that time, maybe that place might give me a peace from the pain I've been hiding for years. When we arrived at bar, it was a noisy place. But it seems people are enjoying. Some people are dancing, some are drinking alcoholic, and some are smoking. I was scared at time because I just had a feeling that something terrible will happen. But the thoughts disappeared when Leslie pulled me to dance on the dance floor. I danced the time, and as time goes by, I found myself enjoying to that place. We only stopped dancing when Kara said that she wanted to drink something. We went to a private room and they ordered drinks.
Hey Clara, drink this. It might help you to have more energy so you can enjoy the whole night.
Thank you.
Claire, you shouldn't smoke too. It helps to lessen the stress that your mother gave you.
I don't think so.
Don't be a baby. Just try it.
You didn't need to swallow the smoke. just do like this. See? You need to practice so you will get used to it.
Hi, Kara and Leslie.
Hey, Kim.
Oh my god, son, you're here?
Of course, I'm always around. And who is this chick?
Clara, she's our friend.
Claire, I'll go to the comfort room.
I'll come with you first. Wait for us, Clara.
They left me with Kim alone. I doesn't like the way he looks at me. I tried to escape, but he stopped me.
Hey Clara, where are you going? Leslie and Kara said that we should wait for them.
I only nodded at them. I was praying that they will be back soon. Ken starts asking questions about me and I feel more scared because 30 minutes have passed and my friends haven't returned yet. Ken offered me a drink, but I refused.
I'm hurt. I'm trying to be your friend, but it seems you don't want to be one of your friends. Listen, please, this is just a cocktail. It won't make you drunk, I promise.
I accept the drink that he is offering me because I don't want to be rude. He might hurt me if I still refuse. He started to get dizzy and so his evil smile. He tricked me. My body is heating up and I feel helpless that time. He started to undress me. I try to shout and ask for help, but to no avail. All I can do is to cry. Ken raped me. Leslie and Kara never returned. They betrayed me. Ken only stopped when a sirens of police mobile cars was heard.
Everybody, don't move. Raise your hands.
In my blurry eyes, Ken was arrested and a man figure appeared and hugged me tight. Jago.
Yes, it's me. Your mother called me last night and asked if you're with me. She's worried about you.
Where is she? Jago bows his head. I know something is wrong. I don't know where I got some bravery to ask him what happened to my mother. Where is my mother?
She had a heart attack right after she knew that you went into the bar. We sent her to the hospital, but it was too late.
No. After that incident, I didn't know what to do. I stopped studying. I started to find jobs, but because of being minor, mostly where I tried to apply, refused to hire me. Jago tried to help me, but I refused. I broke up with him because of the rape incident. I was afraid the time that I might be pregnant, but after a month, I was kind of relieved that I'm not pregnant. I started to accept washing clothes so I can have my own money to live. Until one day, one of my neighbor knocks on the door and gives me something.
Clara, your mother asked me to give it to you before she died. I told her that she should just give it to you personally, but she said that you might not accept it. If you have any concern or any question, don't be shy to knock on my house. Your mother is kind. She's a hardworking woman, I know. Take care, Clara.
My neighbor gave me an envelope, and when I open it, there's an ATM card, some cash, and a letter. I immediately read the letter.
Clara, I love you so much, my daughter. I know you hate me so much because you think I betrayed your father. Our family got broken because of me. I'm actually waiting for the right time to tell you the truth, but I can't get a timing because every time I try to explain, you are already mad at me. It hurts a lot whenever I uncontrollably slap you. It's not my intention to hurt you. Every night, I'm wondering why The truth is, the guy that you saw me embracing the time is your real father. His name is Rodolfo. Even I'm not married to him, he still gives support to you. We are not in a relationship, but he is the best friend of mine. The real reason I get married to your father Raul is my parents caught him raping me before, and they thought he is the reason why I got pregnant. Raul left us because he actually have his own family before you were born. He's not dead. Rodolfo is actually the one who died. That's why I stopped you to see his funeral way. I want you to acknowledge him as a father who passed away. I'm sorry, Clara. Sorry for everything. Use the money from the ATM card for you to leave. All the money from it came from your real father. I keep it because it was meant for you. Take care if I'm already dead. I love you, daughter. Love, Mama.
I don't know what to feel anymore. All I can do that time is to cry every night. I regret all the bad things I did to my mother. All the foul words I said to her. It was too late to realize that I love her and I appreciate her. But now, as of today, I have my own children and happily married with Jago. Yes, to my ex-boyfriend. Many things actually happened. I tried my best to escape my past and move forward. I may not totally move on, but all I can see is it is an unforgettable memory where I learn a lot of things. The key to overcome those past, you need to mature. You need to think to every action you will make if it will affect the persons around you. Life may not be fair, but it's not a reason to be unfair to others. Treasure what you have now than lose it later on, and regrets will suck up you. I wish every listener learned from the story of my life. Very truly yours, Clara.
I can't stop my tears. To Clara, you're a brave woman. I salute you. So to all listeners, my advice would be, don't regret later. Well, it's already time, my dear listeners. Again, I'm DJ Chris, and Drama Rama is signing off.